this. I'm back on my Indo board, and I've only been out of surgery now for 6 days. Ah, that's not exactly the way I had it planned, being out on my Indo board this way. I got a long way to go. I'll tell you what, I said it before, here's my postscript, is I had no idea. It's humbling to know just how far I've got to come back with no hip flexor strength whatsoever. Part of the operation is destroys those hip flexors, and that's where I have no strength right now, is at the whatever to do a crunch or to sit in an upright position, which I'm not allowed to do. I can't sit in a 90 degree angle because the hip flexor won't allow it. Lifting up my leg on my own is the first priority, is to learn how to be able to do that. So a long way to go, and I'll give you some more clues here in just a minute. Get off my endo board and get ready to show you more stuff. All right, here you are. This is where Indo Board headquarters started. I was here for 7 years out of my house before we got to the warehouse. I'm going to navigate over to the computer. I've kind of been neglecting my computer communication with everybody. You know, part of what happens there with the amount of pain meds that you're on is your brain's completely addled. The first 2 days I couldn't even read a newspaper because my brain wouldn't stay focused. It just wanted to drift off because my pain meds may be, you know, almost in a sleep type state. So I really haven't done any emails or much with the computer. But part of what I want to talk about is just the depth of what happens at the hospital and the different things that you go through. Pretty darn amazing. And probably this being one of them, not my wildest dreams to ever think I'd have my own walker. We're going to have to get some stickers and fix this thing up. But literally can't get around without it. I mean, it's what it's all about. And it's learning to walk with a specific gait. And we did that in physical therapy. We showed that earlier. But it's making movements that don't disrupt the hip or make the... What you're trying not to do is let the hip bounce out. So I can't 90 degree angle, again, I've said that before, I can't sit in a 90 degree angle because it'll pop out. I can't turn my foot inward because that makes the hip pop. And I've got to make sure that that knee stays lower than my hip. So getting into proper position is all part of it. But you got to see, I have to have the seats all rigged up. Have to be a minimum of 19 inches. And set up there and pop open. So now, from now on, I can be doing video blogs, and we'll be live, and not live, but we'll have more updates and so on. But really, if you have to go through this, you got to be prepared for all that it takes. It's amazing how far back it throws you into not being able to do a whole heck of a lot for yourself, and just dealing with that on a daily basis, from the drugs and being restricted to bed to having to ask somebody to help you to do just about anything. And the big difference in the hospital, you press a button and somebody comes there and helps you do anything. So here I am at home and there's no button. So Georgette takes care of me very well, and I guess she's going to find a bell or something so I can call her, but it's still, I'll be dependent on her for a long time to get stuff done. 6 weeks I've got to wear my lovely stockings. How do you like that? Just to show you, I forgot about this part. Just call me Thunder Thigh, and that's the swelling in one leg compared to the other, twice the size, and that'll all hopefully disappear over the course of 6 weeks or so. But it's supposedly 6 weeks of wearing these compression socks to keep everything flowing. Blood clots is one of the major concerns. Another concern talking about earlier was pneumonia and the breathing exercises I have to do to keep the chest clear. So a lot of things going on when you do surgery, and it's 5 days after it, and I've got such a long way to go, and someday I'll get my hair washed. Can't take a shower at least for 2 weeks. So we got to figure out some way to get me maneuvered so I can get some water and shampoo going on there so I can improve this mop I've got going on. So anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you learned something here. I guess it's time for some pain meds. So, what I normally would do would be to head right over here. Talk about great pain medication. We got the Indo board logo and everything. But unfortunately, I don't think this will blend real well with the Percocet that I'm on. But in the future, I'm ready. I'm loaded to bear here. But an interesting part of what happened is the pain and the pain medication. The doctor, one of my concerns going in was just how much pain I was going to be in and worrying about medication levels and certainly coming out with a drug addiction, because they got me on liquid morphine, synthetic morphine and Oxycontin, which are highly addictive drugs. But the doctor assured me that it would be a tapering and not an overloading of so many of those that would happen. But the interesting part is I've really had great pain management. I mean, talk about a very invasive surgery and not feeling like, you know, there's a knife stuck in my side. Never pain like that. I've been managed very well and very smooth and easy. I think the only time I had real pain was when we forgot to take one of my Oxycontin on the third day before physical therapy. And I started doing exercises with the physical therapist, and I was in agony, and she said, "Did you get your pain meds?" And I went, "Uh-oh." And that was the only time I really felt true pain associated with what I'm going through here. So, I know it's there. There's a level of pain, about two or three, that's there all the time, letting me know that something's going on. But seriously, I thought I would be in much more agony than I am. So, medication has come a long way. The doctor's really good at prescribing that. So that's something, if you're going to go through this ordeal, is rest assured that if you got a good doctor, they're going to take care of you the right way, and you're not going to feel totally in agony. Spacey, I'll tell you what, in space cases, gets it groggy and in and out of consciousness the first day was one of the strangest things I ever experienced. So that's the pain med story.